bite me, Pacey.
Busted. Hey, be kind, rewind.
Watch it, Joey.
Throwing parties, crashing boats, upstaging marching bands. Dustin, if your rope was any more yank, you'd be a church bell.
Joey, Eva's. Top of the world, you and I.
We've got a lot of time, and it sure feels I left the oven on.
Your life would be considerably more productive if you would just take some more, what is that? Some more, action. If you took more action.
Oh, like voluntary manslaughter?
Well, how about, like, sticking out your thumb, huh?
Oh, yeah? What else? Maybe hike up my skirt, pout my lips, strike some sexy pose for a horn dog trucker? Stick out your own thumb, you sexist toad.
I am not a sexist. I am a pragmatist, okay? You ever seen The Sure Thing? That film elegantly portrays one of life's simple truths. That a female standing on the side of the road, even one with a perpetual scowl such as yourself, has a better chance of flagging down a car than a guy.
Since I'm the only one here with an opposable thumb, I guess it's up to me to use it.
And here's your chance.
Today's your lucky day, Miss Potter. Need a ride back to school?
Thanks.
Oh, Principal Green. Whew. Thank God you are here. In preparing for our botany assignment, it appears that Josephine and I, we wandered significantly farther away from the school than we had anticipated. Frankly, I was beginning to worry that we weren't going to make it home by nightfall.
That's a good one, Pacey.
Well, you know, let it never be said that I'm lacking in the creativity department.
Let's hope you're not lacking in the calamine lotion department either.
Now put down the poison oak
and get your butts in my car.
Permission to come aboard?
Permission granted.
Thank you.
And now, the purpose for our little foray into truancy. What do you say?
True love?
Yeah, it's my girl's name. It's kind of high on the schmaltz factor, huh?
Acutely. That's sweet.
Now remember, I told you I needed your help with something.
With what?
Well, start sanding.
You are so overboard. Now these two, on the other hand, whole different story. I mean, look at them. Look at their form. Look at the tension in their arms.
Okay, is there some sort of problem here?
Well, what did I say about rib cages touching? Can we do that? Sorry.
It's just not gonna happen, all
right? Right. You see what I mean? See the hostility, the way they're wary with each other, not to mention the constant bickering and name-calling. Now, these two, clearly, are in the early stages of some screwball mating ritual.
What?
Okay, you've got it all wrong, lady.
Really? I
do. Oh, completely.
Actually, you could not be more wrong.
There's enough sexual tension here to power a Kiss reunion tour. I can't remember the last time I saw dancing this bad.
True.
Wait a minute, just because they can dance, you think that they're...
Well, it's this theory that I've developed based on years of experience. If people dance that badly, then they're usually hot for each other. The dancing doesn't lie.
Look at that girl, Dawson. Did you just take a good look? She's a freaking goddess, man. How long did you think it was gonna be before some guy comes along and is interested in her? I mean, really, dude? A comedy of errors is probably gonna put the sisters Potter in the poorhouse.
You know what I think? I think that if I were Joey and Bessie, I would consider myself very lucky to have you in my life.
What?
What makes you care so much?
Potter, look, I talked to the furnace guy. He said he could come by tomorrow if he didn't.
it's not too late to bail. Okay? Believe me.
Why would I want to do that, Pacey?
Because this guy's an operator, okay? I can tell. I mean, you know, the first thing he's going to do when he comes through that door is he's going to pay you some lame compliment about how incredible you look tonight.
Pacey.
I'm looking out for you. And then he'll try something cute, like a negligible but not entirely insignificant amount of physical contact, you know what I mean? Like helping you on with your coat.
It's called being a gentleman, Pacey. I'm surprised you've heard of it.
And this party's supposedly taking you to? I bet it doesn't even exist. And if it does exist, I'll lay you money that our boy Wonder over there sees as the first possible opportunity to get you alone.
Stay.
Hey.
Hi.
You look amazing.
I should get my coat.
What are you doing here? Renaissance man bail on you?
No. It was just that it was getting late and the clouds were moving in, and once it's overcast, there's really no chance of actually seeing the northern lights from this latitude, and plus it was getting cold, so we just decided that...
He kissed you, didn't he?
What makes you say that?
You'd have to be a moron not to. And your lipstick is smeared all over your face.
That's what I get for letting Bessie talk me into Very Berry, I guess.
So what, you gonna see this guy again?
I mean, what's the point? He's older than me, he's smarter than me. He lives far away, a very not insignificant problem, seeing as though I can't even drive yet. How could I ever feel about him the way that I...
feel about Dawson?
No, I was actually going to say Phil.
I want to know something, Miss Josephine Potter. I think the world may just surprise you yet. I mean, you fall in love and it doesn't work out, and you think that it'll never happen again, but it does. Believe me, it does, in the strangest of places.
What makes you such an expert, Pacey?
Well, I'm an actor. You know, a poor player, strutting and fretting and all the rest of that Shakespearean stuff, and as such, it is my job to understand the sophisticated inner workings of the human heart.
I think I liked you better when you were brooding and defeatist. What?
Well, I think your date may not be over so soon after all. Go on, you know you want to.
Okay, so it's a girl. Who is she?
You know what, Dougie? It's really not that important, okay?
Okay.
I'll tell you something, though. She is really, really annoying.
Yeah?
Yeah, I mean, this girl is amazing. There is not a single subject on the face of the planet that she doesn't have an opinion about. It's mind-boggling.
Well, that certainly sounds like a nightmare.
Well, no, I mean, it's not quite like that. I mean, you gotta understand it. The girl's really smart, so she's usually right. And when she argues, it comes from this really beautiful, pure place. So, I mean, how can you fight against that, you know, especially if you're a smart ass like me?
Is she pretty?
Yeah, she is pretty. She is very, very pretty. She's actually the kind of pretty that gives you butterflies, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Never lose the butterflies.
What?
You know, that's maybe what sucks most about getting older. Somewhere along the line, you just lose the butterflies. So the question is, little brother, what are you going to do about it?
Do?
Yeah, do, as in do something. Take action.
No, I don't think you're really properly grasping the gravity of this situation, Dougie. You see, if I was actually to do something about this, there is the strong possibility that the sun would cease to shine, that the tides would cease to rise. In fact, I'm betting there's a pretty good chance that the very earth would crack open and Capeside would become home to a huge hellmouth that would spew forth endless hordes of monsters and demons that would choke the denizens of this city, making them fall to their knees and pray for a return to the days before I took action. That's really what we're talking about here.
Huh. Yeah, maybe. Look, Pacey, in my experience, you don't come across that many people with the ability to give you butterflies. You just don't. And if you don't tell this girl how you feel, well, it'll be like spending the rest of your life in your own personal prison.
Hey, Doug?
Yeah.
Thank you.
So you did it. You rallied to a certain someone's side in a very ducky-like manner.
Yeah, mission accomplished.
How do you feel?
To be honest, I feel like dog meat. She didn't even thank me.
She will. One day.
How can you be so sure?
Because every duck has his day. Just ask Henry.
Father, right up here. A couple more steps. Right here. Whoa, stop. Right there. Perfect. We're here.
Hey, see, I don't know where you think here is, but it seems to me we're nowhere.
Think back with me for just a second. Do you remember how this whole thing started? It started with a girl, a wall, and a paintbrush.
You bought me a paintbrush.
No, lame-o. I stole this from your permanent collection.
You bought me a wall?
Not bought. Rented. And this thing didn't come cheap either. It cost me $100.
You bought me a wall?
You said that already. Look, it's a limited time offer, so you should get cracking.
Pacey, did you fail to notice the size of this thing?
I just thought your next endeavor should be bigger and better than your last one. It's important that you keep on growing both as a person and as an artist. I also got you this. Now, I know it's not going to cover the whole thing, but as the saying goes, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
I'm going to need your help on this one.
No. Not this time. You're on your own, sister.
Pacey, you're unbelievable. I mean, as soon as I think I have you all figured out, you go and you do something so outrageous that, I mean, completely challenges me in a way that no one else would even think of, that... In case I don't say it enough. Thank you.
It's about time, Potter. It's about time.
Have you totally lost it?
No, not totally. Yet. All right, what did you mean by that?
Well, what?
About me knowing you better than anybody else.
Exactly what I said, Pacey. You know me, okay? In a way that nobody else besides Dawson ever has.
We're not talking about Dawson right now. We're talking about me. I mean, you can't keep on doing this to me, Potter.
Doing what? What, so I count on you and I tell you secrets
and
suddenly...
And you call me in the middle of the night to pick you up. Why?
Well, I'm sorry that I called. I thought that I...
I'm not mad that you called me. I just want to know why you called me.
You were the first person that I thought of, Pacey.
And what does that mean, Joe?
It means that... I guess it... It means that I can talk to you and that you're there for me.
Don't you ever get tired of talking?
No. No, well, I don't get tired. Well, I don't know.
I don't want to talk anymore.
What are you trying to say,
Joe,
Pacey? Why are we standing?
There's comfort. Take comfort. Where...